Well, good morning, folks. I've been spotting this for a long time. Well, a while, about a month, I think. Out with Dan and Tony up at Loch Locky. We've been here for 2 days. I haven't done any filming because the weather has been horrendous. I mean, horrendous. And I just didn't want to bother. But we came up on Saturday night, well, Saturday day, pitched, and Tony came up yesterday, so we hung about, and Tony didn't get up until about 5 o'clock, so really we just stayed here last night, and last night was a rough night with the wind and the rain, but as always we get through it. So today, hopefully, the plan of attack is to have some breakfast, then have some breakfast, get the canoes going and paddle up the loch. We're here for 4 or 5 days, so the plans, there's no set plans, we're just going to do what we can do. So we'll see what happens. Well, there's the camp. We're just starting to sort of get ourselves sorted out, get the mess sorted out. We've got the fishing rod, so we're going to have a little bit of fish. This is what was here when we came. This is what I mean. This is why people get peed off with their wild campers. Look at that. Plastic bottles and everything. And we've actually tidied it up a little bit. We had a little, what looks a little dilapidated now. Oh, so we just had a couple of nights in here, and we've just been using a little portable barbie as a fire, just to get out the wind and the rain, you know, just have some food. There's the Darren's got his tea on, or his breakfast, should I say. This is what we've had to cope with for the last 2 days, the wind and the rain, and it's supposed to get worse with regards to snow, but snow coming in, I think. Never mind. It is what it is, and we will do what we do. Look at down the lock there.
was not to be.
Well, as you can see, we've moved camp. Got the canoes up off the bank. And set a camp up again. But what you don't know is that down there is where we camped last night. We got out in a canoe. Tony broke her paddle. He had a spare. But Loch Locky, if anybody's fished Loch Locky before, will know that it changes in a heartbeat. As beautiful as it is, that water just picks up and it is impossible, literally impossible. It's not impossible, it's just dangerous to canoe. I mean, you can see the white horses there now in the distance. It's calmed down a little bit now. It looks lovely, but no, it's not worth the risk. At the end of the day, we're here to enjoy ourselves. We're not here to put ourselves in danger. So we've come. Basically come back from where we were in the canoe. I mean, we only actually paddled to just beyond that point. That's as far as we've got. We've got around the corner, we're in the slipstream of the wind, and pretty bloody impossible, to be fair, to paddle, to keep straight. And the waves were getting bigger and bigger and bigger. So we made the call to come back. We're going to camp here tonight, get some bait, and decide what we're going to do tomorrow. But you know what it is, look around, it's just stunning, lovely place. We can hear that wind if I put you in the wind. Against when you're on the water with that wind, it's yeah, it's no good. No good. But we're still out, still enjoying myself. As you can see, I need a shave and a shower and a bath, and I stink. Think I'm gonna we're gonna get onto the water for a good paddle up the loch this week, because the forecast is torrential rain and snow tonight and tomorrow. We had that last night, but it's supposed to get a lot colder and the wind's supposed to pick up, so I can't see we're getting on the water, to be honest. But we will do something, and I'll bring you back later on. But it's a beautiful place, beautiful spot, and we are basically, there's the cars. I don't like camping next to the car, but such is life. So I'm not going to lie to you and say we're a million miles away from the cars, because we are not. There you go, they're there. And we've got gear all over the place. that's still a nice view to look up to and wake up to in the morning. Well, we've tried to actually get onto the water and have a paddle, but as you can see by the weather, it's just crap, and the forecast is to get worse. But snow showers, heavy wind. So what we're going to do is we're going to pack up, go and have a shower and a shave in one of the canal toilets, which I've got the key for, and then head into Fort William and have some breakfast or dinner, depending on what time we'll get there. Still be nice to get out, but unfortunately we just couldn't get out for a paddle. We've had a lot of snow last night. You'll not be able to see it, but it's come down and covered the lowland areas rather than the Nevis range. So yes, so unfortunately this is probably going to be it for this part of the trip. We're going to try and head to Loch Etive, and see what it's like over there. By the time we get over there, it might have calmed down, we can get on the water, but we'll have a wild camp somewhere around Glencoe, I would think, for a couple of days. Well, hello folks, how are you doing? After a little unsuccessful canoe trip, or should I say a lack of canoe trip, we decided to move slightly further south towards the Bridge of Locky area. And obviously we can't go too far away from the vehicles with the tents. I just want to keep an eye on the canoes. So we found a beautiful little spot. It's about 6 miles from the Bridge of Locky. It's a lovely spot. I'll show you around. This is the car park, as you can imagine. It's nothing special, but when you come in this direction, it's still very, very windy. Very windy, so hopefully I'll try and shelter the camera from the wind while I'm talking. So it's not wild camping before anybody says, but you know it is. Just got to do what you do. So we found this little gem here. It's in the middle of nowhere, but the views are spectacular. And we've just had a hailstorm. That's the hail that came off the top. If I'd had the camera, I would have showed you it when it was coming down. So there you go. That's my view in the morning across the lock, and then it just gets better. Thank you. boat happening. Lovely. So we're going to get ourselves sorted out, and then we're going to have a little walk just to see what's going on. There's a big herd of deer, but you'll not be able to pick them up on the GoPro. I'll quickly show you myself for that, because I've got the Hilleberg Solo. The camera's gone now, all the place now. I've got the Hilleberg Solo with a little top extension on it. Not me normal extension that I carry, which I take up in the hills because it's nice and light, but a big one. There you go. So that's the setup. Ideally if you've got a set of oars light, but a set of walking sticks would do. Just gives you a little place to get cooking in, you know, getting dressed in, putting your boots in, whatever it is, getting up in the middle of the night when you have to. So there you go. Get me kitten bags on a tree drying, because it got a little bit wet last night. That is what I'm going to wake up to in the morning. Got to be good. I think these videos I put, these next couple of videos I'm going to be putting them, they're going to be about 5 minutes long, because there's not a great deal to show you apart from the views. I'll get some time lapses done and what have you. And I'm getting Eddie, I've got my new camera, the LX100, so I'm going to try shooting some night scenes, skies and what have you. We shall see. But there you go. We've had horrendous snow over the last sort of 8 hours, and the wind has just been terrible. That's basically why we're never